next one. That's me. Good morning. Right, our journey as a Queen's nurse. I don't want anything to get into your head from the subliminal messages I might be putting out through this presentation, but I'm just a small town girl. What Claire was saying about your identity and who I am, I'd quite like to add Pirate Queen to the end of that now. One of the things about becoming a Queen's nurse was what I'm going to present is that a lot of this work had already begun, but this last year just accelerated the whole thing, amplified everything that's made it work. So I was living in a lonely world. I'm a senior charge nurse in forensic examination, police custody, healthcare, and it's quite a new speciality. But one of the things that I wanted to do in my project was concentrate on the four pillars of health inequalities, which is very grand and very worthy. It's also very real, and I hope to sort of present things that we did with the Queen's Nurse right behind us to make it work for the people that we look after, who are marginalised, disenfranchised, and actually pretty poorly, and wanting to be happier than they are. So first was improving mental health and well-being. And I use this because it's the tango, it's the authentic, and the moments of drama, we've all had them within our clinical lives, great import, when you really look at your colleagues and you just go, well, that was a close one, or that's really sad, or whatever it is. But there's something really authentic about what we do together every day. And I sold it to my team about creating a person-centered culture, so we've got to be here anyway. Okay, we're going to be here anyway. And we're talking about person-centeredness for our patients. How about for us? How about the best that we can possibly be? Yes, we're a beating team. It'd be nice if we're an award-winning team. Yeah. But it's actually, we're going to be here for 20, 30 years, whatever. I want to look back on my time ago if that was incredible. The stuff we did, and the spiky over there, and in here, and you've got a team. What a great team. And so, sometimes it's in the dance that's in the dance. I'm not going to dance. that we find these authentic moments of pure drama, and nursing can be pure drama. Remember, they make television programs about us. So it's, we took the midnight train anywhere. We didn't know. I mean, there was the, we know about social determinants of ill health, blah, 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 blah. How did we make it work? So, tackling drugs and alcohol, I focused in on something called Oroquick. This clinical stuff. Three Bridges Project. This is about bloodborne violence testing in police custody. Never been done before. We did a small test of change, found it 25% incidence. Those of you should know, it's 1% in the general public. So it was a no-brainer. But how do we deliver that? How do we do it? Well, there's this technology that you can use a little blood test and you get a result within 20 minutes. So you're contained. And with my colleagues in the infectious diseases unit and the blood and virus testing team, we can refer our people straight away, and we've got excellent coverage with public health. Now the real point of that, because we know we can get better from Hep C, is that we get our folk into treatment. If they begin to trust us, they might trust whole journey. They might just feel better. Whatever it is, we're getting people through the door. Early doors, but there you go. And Three Bridges, see what I did there? And Three Bridges. Yeah. So it does go on and on and on. The blood and violence goes on and on and on. We're just all the time faced with violence. Violence in our society. Violence. The more I know about it, the less I understand it. So what could we do? Well, it's about engagement. And not, we can't win everything, but we can at least try. You know, we give it a go. So, reducing violence, you might have heard of Queen's Nursing Awards or grant from Catalyst for Change that I got some years ago called Sunday Choices. And that's grown and grown and grown and grown. It was basically a teachable moment in custody, get people in from the third sector to actually talk to those people. It's a proven concept now. Public Health have endorsed it, and Police Scotland have endorsed it. So it's now a thing, a real thing. Now I'll put this slide it together, because for me this was a process. And putting together a stakeholder, a sort of a faculty, if you like, is what I've done. And we had our first proper meeting of the faculty of arrest referral. And personally, sadly, Scotland, we will change the name. Someone suggested, what was it? Arrest referral in South East Scotland, or ARSIS. Thank you, anyway, what we're going for is a South East Scotland approach that is so simple, and the simplicity, so simple. Get the people that can help into custody where the people actually are. You would have no idea how difficult that's been. But we've done it, and it's all about relationship building. It's all about the chat. It's all about everything that we do. So, it was very complicated, but just put it like this. We've gone from no to all of this sort of thinking, reflecting, to superheroes, and that, yes, and it's out. So it has worked, so watch that space. Reducing trauma, this is important. And it's all about the sexual assault and rape work that we do. Did you know that nurses aren't allowed to give opinion evidence in Scottish courts? Well, anyway, we'll be tackling that. But hugely been a very big activist in that. Watch this space, there's more to come. This will be a speciality very, very soon. And be endorsed by university, by the Crown Office and Scottish Government. Be busy. So that's what we do. If you want to talk to me about that, that would be really, 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 really happy to do that. But people are marginalised, and we need to make sure that at the most vulnerable, we are looking after them, if we are tasked and funded to do that. What I can say about the Queen's Nurses is, and it's following on from what Barbara said, so I'm not going to repeat that, but I echo everything she said. You choose your mood every day when you go in. You choose that. You choose to succeed. It's difficult. Of course it's difficult. But keep communicating and never, ever give up. So yesterday we were talking about writing for a publication. And I started writing, which was sort of tricked into writing an abstract. But it was very handy for this morning. But the last bit of it I wrote, it's so complex, but the main thing is to have the relationships. Have the opportunity to have a human experience, to care and be cared for. The science is there, we're just applying it. Applying it so it works. We all get to belong to it, because it was always ours to begin with. And what I would say is that all roads lead to engagement. We're doing it right now. And we all want to belong, whoever we are. And a wise woman once said, you're not living until you're living out of your comfort zone. And that's where I became doing the Queen's Nurse programme. So becoming a Queen's Nurse, I have found my tribe, I have found my nursing family, I have found that I am not my contract, I am a social reformer. I am in the social movement, and I've made a lifelong commitment. Thank you.